Not my faculty and staff card.
Hello. This is gonna take a while. All right, we'll handle this together. It'll be fun. So today I'm going to Target. I would show you my room, but it is an actual disaster. And there's just like a lot of different ways you can save money, even at a place that typically is like average to more expensively priced. So I've created a shopping list of not just food, but also little incidentals that I might need and like a couple things that I bought who knows how long ago, and I'll see if they let me return them if I'm very nice. And yeah, it'll be a good time. So I'm gonna film myself inside of a store in public. I bought this camera, now I have to film myself in public. That's the deal. So since I haven't been living on my own that long, I'm always trying to figure out how often I should go to the store. And it really just depends. Most of the time it's because I realize I have basically only like chips, which is good because it means I'm eating things proportionally, but it's also not good when you're like, oh, I'm just eating Oreos out of the freezer, got it. Just pay attention to your body and it will let you know if it needs greens, if it needs fruit, especially if the thought of eating another quesadilla just makes you want to never even look at sharp cheddar again. That's when it's time to go get your produce and go get your other vitamins besides whatever comes in simple carbs. I'm gonna find my keys, wherever those may be, and then we're gonna head out. It's gonna be great.
I've been in my car for 2 hours, literally just trying to figure out a car mount. I couldn't find a hex key, which if you don't know what that is, neither do I. I started doing this at 5:15. Nope, maybe 4:40, and it is 6:35. You have to try a lot of different angles on the dashboard. You don't want to be illegal and have like a camera obscuring all of your vision, but you also want to have an okay picture, and it's just a lot. Did I forget my tripod? Oh, I didn't. I wasn't about to swear. Don't hit the board. I think we're Gucci. I think we're good to go. You better be. I've been trying to go to Target for 2 hours. And I'm really hungry. My blood sugar is plummeting at a rapid pace. Aw, he gave blood. Good job. Is my trunk open? Please don't hurt me. Please. Let me go left. Let me. Illegal! To be fair, there's a lot of like, laws in Los Angeles. Like, when you have to yield on a left turn and you're driving anywhere at a time where there might be traffic ever, it's like, hey, don't go on a red, but if you've been waiting for actually 2 minutes, like, just go. Or at least hopefully that's the rule. I've been doing it that way for quite a while. I'm at a stoplight. Not my faculty and staff card. No. Okay, wait. You can look out the side. So we are in the gorgeous Westwood Village. It's a really cute area. There's a lot of cool places to hang out. That's a red. To be fair, I was already in the intersection. I was just finishing the direction. What are you doing? Why? If you want to learn how to deal with uncomfortable feelings of anger, drive in LA for 1 second. As much as I love this intersection, let's get back to the real star here. Oh, Target, here we go. Oh, parking anywhere. I've just recently carried around a little sack of quarters and now my coin jingles when I walk around like a pirate, but it's a really good way to not have to give your card to meters because it just takes a while. It's like in Pasadena, I had to download an app to pay for like half hour parking. I don't know who thought that would be a simpler solution to everything, but whoever they were objectively wrong. If you're going to the grocery store, it's really worth its weight in gold to just go somewhere that either validates for parking or is 2 hours free parking with validation. That's why I always go to my local city Target. But I do, it's really nice to not have to deal with that. And occasionally I've gone to lunch with somebody, parked at Target, right before the 2 hours are up, I like buy a piece of gum and validate. So it's not against the law. It's just kind of like, don't do that all the time. Like buying something you need to wear for one work event and returning it, which is wrong. Don't do it. Except maybe once. Apparently it's a slippery service. It's the ice age here in Los Angeles. All right, we'll see you on the inside. Life, it seems like only yesterday. Pro tip, if you're ever too cold in Target, you can get warm by all the stress you're having from buying things you can't afford. So I just made a depressing realization that frozen pizza makes a lot more sense when you have an oven that works. So that might not happen today, but you know, a girl can dream.
Bagel bites.
Oh, I'm over it. These are delicious. So this is a really good example of how to survive. How to save money buying products. For example, as you can see, this, and sometimes it's even with the same brand, like this Kraft mac and cheese is $5.99 and it needs to get over itself. We're gonna go to a lower aisle and you can see that these ones are $1.52, basically the same thing. And so I'm gonna pick up these. I don't know if I pay more for this because of branding, so I'm gonna do this. As much as I love R2D2. I mean, the smaller, fatter one. All right, and I don't have milk, so that would be difficult to make mac and cheese without milk. And hopefully it doesn't freeze as fast as almond milk, because that'd be bad. So you might be wondering what the difference is between reduced milk and skim milk and low-fat milk, and the answer is I don't know. But you can usually look a little bit closer and it'll let you know. Most of the time it's the same thing, they're just trying different marketing strategies. So I'm gonna go with 2% because live a little. Yeah, let's get a big one. I feel like I'll be having a lot of mac and cheese. Did I do two? Oh, I'm so sneaky. My subconscious is aggressive. Oh, goodness. See, this is worth it because we already have our grilled chicken to mix with it. So since I have a lot of chicken, I might even get two of these because this looks delicious. I just have to remember to actually consume it, which doesn't always happen. Oh, but this looks good too. Asian, cabbage, iceberg, celery, red cabbage. Okay, anything but the chicken. So now we have two salads ready. There it was. So pro tip, if you're hungry when shopping, just buy something and eat it before you pay for it. And then pay for it. I should clarify that. Were I a more savvy shopper, I would check out most of my things at self-checkout and then take my two alcoholic items to the real checkout. But I'm not that, and I'm quite lazy, so we're gonna do it the hard way. So something marginally unexpected has happened. I was at checkout.